Hello everyone. In the database management system, today we are discussing about transaction management. What is transaction? A transaction is a sequence of operations performed in a single logical unit of work. Basically, a transaction is a logical unit of work that contains one or more SQL statement. For example, we can see here a complete transaction, read A, A equals to A minus 50, write A, write B, B equals to B plus 50, write B. There is two operations, read A to write A is the first operation and read B to write B is the second operation. And the whole process is known as the transaction and the unit is known as the single unit. ACID property of transactions. Atomicity means either transaction execute 0% or 100%. Consistency means database must remain in a consistent state after any transaction. Isolation depicts intermediate transactions result must be hidden from other concurrency executed transactions. The durability is known about once a transaction completed successfully, the changes it has made into the database should be permanently. ACID property of transactions in detail. Atomicity. First, we are taking first atomicity. This property states that a transaction must be treated as an atomic unit. That is, either all of its operation are executed or none. Either transaction execute 0% or 100%. For example, consider a transaction to transfer rupees 50 from account A to account B. In this transaction, if rupees 50 is deducted from A, then it must be added to account B. Else, the whole process will be reverted back. So we can see here about the in the numeric also the atomicity of the in of the transaction. Consistency. The database must remain in a consistent state after a transaction. If a database was in a consistent state before the execution of a transaction, it must remain consistent after the execution of the transaction as well. In our example, total of A and B must remain same before and after the execution of the transaction. We can see here the starting value of A is 500 and the starting value of B is 500. A plus B equals to 1000. Read A. A equals to A minus 50. Write A. Read B. B equals to B plus 50. Write B. A equals to 450 and B equals to 550. And ultimately at the last, the sum of A plus B equals to 1000. So there is a consistency as a starting point A plus B equals to 1000 and the ending point the value of A plus B equals to 1000 again. ACID property of transaction in this we are taking isolation here. Changes occur in a particular transaction will not be visible to any other transaction until it has been committed. Intermediate transactions result must be hidden from other concurrently executed transactions. In our example, once our transaction start from first step, its result should not be accessed by any other transaction until last step 6 is completed. So we can see here, read A equals to A minus 50, write A, read B, B equals to B plus 50, write B. So till the step write B executes, other any transaction or procedure cannot be interfere or interact with the transactions, current transaction. Now durability. After a transaction completes successfully, the changes it has made to the database persistent or permanent even if there are system failure. Once our transaction completed up to the last step, its result must be stored permanently. It should not be removed if system fails. So we can see here, whatever the result we are getting after the completion of process, it should be always remain on the hard disk on the database. transaction state diagram, state transition diagram. Here we can see there is a diagram. The first step is active, second is partial committed, then committed, then end. This is the first cycle in which process committed. The second cycle, active, partial committed, failed, abort and end. And the third cycle would be active, failed, abort and end. So there is a three type of transaction states may be possible in this diagram. What is the meaning of active state? This is the initial state. The transaction says in this state while it is executing. Partial committed, when a transaction executes its final operation or instruction, it is said to be in a partially committed state. The failed state, discover the normal execution can no longer proceed. Once a transaction cannot be completed, any changes that is made must be undone, rolling it back. What is meaning about committed? The transaction enters in the state after successful completion of the transaction. We cannot abort or roll back a committed transactions. Abort it. The state after the transaction has been rolled back and the database has been restored to its state prior to start the transaction. That's another abort. Now we're discussing about the scheduling. What is scheduling? A schedule is a process of grouping the transactions into one and executing them in a predefined order. A schedule is the chronological order in which instructions are executed in a system. A schedule is required in a database because when some transactions execute in parallel, they may affect the result of the transactions. Means if one transaction is updating the value which the other transaction is accessing, then the order of these two transactions will change the result of another transaction. Hence, a schedule is created to execute the transactions. You can see here the example of a schedule. There is a transaction T1 and transaction T2. The whole A equals the numerical value. We can see here the transaction T1, T2 and the final stage of the transactions. Also, this is the second example of the transaction. T1 is a separate transaction, T2 is a separate transaction, and the whole process is given in the third image. We can divide schedule in a three major sections. The first section is the first kind of the schedule is serial schedule. A serial schedule is one in which no transaction start until a running transaction has ended. Transactions are executed one after the other. This type of schedule is called a serial schedule as transactions are executed in a serial manner. This is the example of the serial schedule manner. First, we completed T1 transaction. After that, we get to start and complete the T2. Interleaved schedule. Schedule that interleaves the execution of different transactions means second transaction is started before the first one could end, and execution can switch between the transaction back and forth. So here we can see that transaction T and transaction T1. At first start T2, then switch to T1, then T2, then T1. Again, second example of interleaved schedule. Now equivalent schedule. If two schedules produce the same result after execution, they are said to be equivalent schedule. They may yield the same result for the sum value and different result for another set of values. That's why this equivalence is not generally considered significance. This is the example of equivalent schedule. We can see here. This is enough for this section. Thank you. Thank you for attending the section.